Bonjour, French students. Welcome to your lesson 10, part F in pronunciation lesson. So lesson 10 is about le l'usage de l'article défini dans avec les jours de la semaine. So the use of the definite article with the days of the week. Again, remember the definite articles. Mean the, we have the masculine, we have the feminine, we have the singular, we have the plural, we have le, la, and the plural is les. Remember, le and la become l apostrophe before a vowel or a silent h. Okay? So that's what we're talking about when we're talking about definite articles. And it says, compare the following sentences. For repeated events, le samedi, je dîne avec des copains. Meaning, on Saturdays, like every Saturday, I have dinner with friends. Versus a single event, samedi, je dîne avec mon cousin. Saturday, like this one Saturday, I'm having dinner with my cousin. Okay, so when in French we're talking about a repeated or habitual event, so that means something that happens every week on that day of the week. That's what we mean by a habitual or repeated event, okay? So events like that, you put le. Notice we only are going to use le, so the only one we're using with the days of the week is the le, okay? We're not using these other definite articles for days of the week, and then the day of the week. When an event happens only once, no article is used. So that's how you distinguish in French between something you do every week on that day of the week, or it's just something you're doing once. So that means that you might want to review the days of the week, which are right here for you. Right? S'il vous plaît, répétez lundi, lundi, mardi, mardi, mercredi, mercredi, jeudi, jeudi, vendredi, vendredi, samedi, samedi, dimanche, dimanche. Now, remember what they mean, right? The French typically would start a calendar or a week with Monday. So lundi is Monday, mardi is Tuesday, mercredi is Wednesday, jeudi is Thursday, vendredi is Friday, samedi is Saturday, and dimanche is Sunday. Okay, so to say that you do something every week on the same day of the week, you put a le in front of it. So if you visit your grandparents every Sunday, then you would write the sentence, okay, le dimanche, je visite ma grand-mère, let's say, so our grandma. Okay, meaning every Sunday I visit my grandmother. All right, the last thing in lesson 10 is the pronunciation, les articles le et les. Be sure to distinguish between the pronunciation of le and les. In spoken French, that is often the only way to tell the difference between a singular and a plural noun. S'il vous plaît, répétez le sac, le vélo, Le portable. Le copain. Le voisin. S'il vous plaît, répétez les sacs, les vélos, les portables, les copains, les voisins. So what they're talking about here, about the only way to tell the difference is, notice when I say these two, one right after the other, right? See, you don't repeat, just listen. We have le sac, les sacs. The only way to tell the difference is the pronunciation. Le vélo, les vélos. Le portable, les portables. The le instead of the les is telling you whether it is singular or plural. So that pronunciation, that difference in how you say le and les is very important. So that brings us to your homework, which is on page 159. Exercise 15, you need to answer the questions in complete sentences. So we'll take a look at that for a moment. It says, question personnelle, parler. Again, this is going to be a writing one for you. So we have number one, est-ce que tu étudies le samedi? That question is asking, do you study on Saturdays, right? And the le is telling you every Saturday. Number two, est-ce que tu dînes au restaurant le dimanche? Si oui, avec qui? So that's asking, do you have dinner at a restaurant on Sundays, as in every Sunday? And if yes, with whom? Trois, est-ce que tu as une classe de français le lundi, le mercredi? So that one's asking, do you have a French class on Mondays, on Wednesdays? Quatre, est-ce que tu regardes les matchs de football américain le samedi, le dimanche? Do you watch American football games on Saturdays, on Sundays? So again, right, this one here and this one here, your answers are going to require two sentences because you're going to answer once for the first day they ask about and then again for the second day. In numéro 5, est-ce que tu travailles ou the name of the place or store and cold. So, do you work, where, when? So, again, if you do have a job, you're going to end up answering that in a couple sentences. Au revoir, à demain.